And then with Moose, he's a left guard, picks it up, and he thinks he's going to go one touch, but he was very much touched by three defenders.
Ron Ellis led the way. Here's Brown. Brown battling his way to the position. Line and out of bounds. Gary Brown. Gary Brown. Getting
out of bounds.
Getting out of bounds. Getting out of the third down.
And football is a game of important plays at different points in the game. Right now, this third down is a very important play for Penn State. They're down by 14. They're driving. They need to keep that going and get on the scoreboard. An important play here for Penn State. Between wins and losses, because Timpson was wide open for a catch and a touchdown. He was overthrown by Fax.
Ray Tarasi over the 41-yard field goal. Lance Ronica has put it down. 31. And it's stopped by West Virginia.
They like to put him right in the middle and let him do it. This time it's number 66, Deron Ellis. The 6'1" who gets way up, gets that right paw. That's a terrific leap by Ellis and well timed.
Major Harris and that explosive West Virginia offense coming back with a first down at the 37. They lead Penn State by 2 touchdowns here in the opening quarter. The lone setback. 3 wide receivers, and Taylor goes nowhere as Jokin at 42 is the first Nittany line to hit him.
Craig Taylor is a very good fullback for the Mountain Virginia because they have a primary block every play. No huddle play here by West Virginia.
And the 3 wide receivers with just Taylor. Harris getting protection. To a first down with Karpinski wiping the receiver up right there. Let's check in with Jim Nance.
Some wild things happening in the Big 8. 2 field goals by Jeff Jackie in Missouri leads with 7 minutes before the half over Nebraska. Kansas threw for 140 yards in the first quarter, even up with Oklahoma starting the second. Let's go back to Brent.
All right, they were going without a huddle, and they were held up momentarily. The ball is at the 47-yard line. First and 10, they did a quick measurement. Lynn was the receiver that time. Now here comes Taylor. They hammer away across midfield and down to the 45.
And Brett, the reason they're going without a huddle is they're trying to prevent substitution by the Penn State defense. It's a good adjustment by Don Nealon and his staff.
Now Harris sparking the play at the line of scrimmage. He has Bell, Rimbert, and Phillips as his wide men. They run Taylor on that draw play, and he may have gotten still another first down.
And anytime Major Harris has the ball in his hands and threatens to get to the corner of the defense as he gets there, you have to react. Then he ran the little draw to Taylor inside.
That is the 10th first down for West Virginia on minute 6. No time for the situation substitute. Harris back now. The offensive line keeping plenty of time. The running back, and he's to the 39 with Jokinen, who has been very active, hammering him out of bounds along with Collins.
Terrific protection. An offense, we said, starts with line play. Watch the time that Major Harris has here. Kokan inside, Kovac, Troya, all those guys inside give him plenty of time to find a receiver.
6 yards to go for the first down. Still in the opening quarter, West Virginia leading 14-0. Harris runs out of trouble again. Now he throws. He was behind the line. It is wide receiver at the 27-yard line with a first down pass. And Willie Thomas making the stop.
One of the things that Calvin Phillips does does so well is adjust to the ball as West Virginia continues to go with their no-huddle offense. This is a nice play by Don Nealon, getting the preventing the substitution from coming in. Because he has so much scrambling ability. The ball goes off the helmet, and there number 30, Hamilton has it and then drops it. With the rush of quarterback like Harris, you have to rush from the outside, I think, Brent, to keep him in the pocket.
Joe Paterno across the way, and a timeout has been called by West Virginia. How experienced is this line of West Virginia, Pat?
When you look at the top 10 teams across the country, look at all the starts that West Virginia has had. They go, these guys have played 4 years next to one another. And in no other part of the team do you need the kind of teamwork and cooperation that you need as you do in the offensive line. These guys really care about each other. Every Thursday night, they go out to dinner together, they room together. It's a good group.
Five seniors. Ryan Smider. Bob Kovac. Kevin Kokas. John Stroyer. Rick Phillips, probably the most important part of a football team. Certainly John Madden among those who believe that you start with the offensive line. And Don Nealon knows he's got a good one.
Every good team that I have been around has had leadership out of the offensive line. Koken and Troya, two of offensive linemen, are co-captains of this Mountaineer team.
Big third down for the Penn State defense. A.B. Brown back at tailback. Drake Taylor, the fullback. It is third and long. Get to the 16 for a first and 10. The ball is resting at the Penn State 25. Harris on the option has Brown on the outside. Brown to the 20. First down to the 15 with Chris Cesar bringing him down. As we come to the end of the first quarter here in Morgantown, West Virginia. We'll return after this message and a word from your for 45, including a touchdown. They've rushed for 111, and Penn State only 21 rush. Now, Penn State has also passed for 29 yards, so their total yards should be 50. It is 201 to 50. This is a first and 10 for the major, who sends his fullback in motion, tosses to his tailback behind the fullback, and he splashes inside to the 12-yard line with Brian Chismar, number 28, who is slowed by an injury today and has not been very active, coming up to make that stop. Don Nealon has got a team that's as impressive as any we have seen this year.
Everybody thinks that this is Don Nealon's first good team. It is not. This is not an overnight success story. He has been in five bowl games his first 8 years here at West Virginia. He's looking for his first major bowl this year.
But he has the nemesis on the other side of the field, unable to beat Joe Paterno. Thought he had it last year and it slipped away. They pound straight ahead and they're stuffed by the middle of that Penn State defense. So this will bring up a third and long.
Penn State is very difficult to score on, particularly running the ball from the 15-yard line in. They play pretty much an eight-man front all over the field. You have much more success throwing the ball in than running against this defense.
Now the ball is at the Penn State 12-yard line, indicating how tough they are against the run. Anthony Brown goes wide to the right, and they They put Bell in the backfield. They toss it to him, swinging around to the left. Now he's going to throw it. Keeps it inside the 10. Battles his way to the 7-yard line with a penalty marker down on the far side. So a bit of a wrinkle. Bell, Francis Bell, they put him at tailback, gave him the option pass, brought him to the left, moved the regular tailback out to the right, but a penalty marker on the far side. And it is against West Virginia, a little too fancy that time, and this penalty will hurt him.
And very, very tough to get the ball in the end zone, running the ball up the gut. They had to try to come up with a trick play as they did there, or throwing the ball downfield, or perhaps Major Harris on the option play.
Joe Paterno watching as the options are explained. It'll be third and 12 as the ball is brought back to the 17-yard line.
So, Brent, you mentioned it at the top. It is absolutely astounding to me that Joe Paterno, in 38 years of coaching, has never had a losing season. That's remarkable.
And Phillips are the wide receivers, wins the tight end. Harris pulls out of the option. He's hammered by Neil Hamilton, number 30, who comes in with a huge defensive play for the Nittany Lions.
And Neil Hamilton was the one who should have had the interception a few plays ago, but that time makes a nice play off the corner. Very top of the screen on the right top. You'll see number 30, he was lined up as a linebacker. Harris had his back to him by the time he saw him. We actually never did see him, but Hamilton did a nice job, so Harris could not get rid of the ball.
Now, there was a penalty marker thrown at the 1-yard line on that play.
And now what West Virginia has to be thinking is,
penalty marker was thrown because of illegal participation.
12 men on the field, defense.
Oh, mercy. What a mental blunder.
Top of the screen, you're going to see some confusion there. Again, uncharacteristic of a Joe Paterno team. They both stayed in, and that's what a penalty was. I wonder they're so tough to score on down there. They had 12 guys in.
Will tend to do it. That is so uncharacteristic of a Joe Paterno coach team. Seldom in the past have the Nittany Lions beaten themselves. Now it is third and 3. Wipes out that defensive play by Hamilton. Harris trying to cut back in, and they stop him short. Neil Hamilton again, number 30. He's out of Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, senior, getting the job done, and they have forced West Virginia to go for the field goal.
Again, once again, Neil Hamilton makes the play, playing outside linebacker. He's playing a lot more. He fights off the tight end block. He's not just good on the open side. He can fight through the tight end and make the play on Harris as he did right there.
Bauman to attempt a 24-yarder.
Thing that I've ever seen to grass. It's very kind on the legs. Let me show you why. First of all, it has a really thick cushion underneath. And then the synthetic fiber here is not glued down, but rather tons of sand are poured between it, and it allows for give, kind of a little slide when a player cuts so his leg doesn't lock. But the biggest recommendation I've ever heard is saying that a coach, West Virginia, Don Nealon, likes to practice on this as much as on grass field. Now, that's something else. Now, back to you, Brent.
Thanks, John. Two new running backs for Penn State. Sam Gash ahead of Thompson, number 44, and he slashes his way to the 37-yard line. Dale Jackson, 93, bringing him down. So Leroy Thompson out of Knoxville, Tennessee, with his first carry of the day. Number 11, Gash, is the story. He missed the Alabama game because of an ankle injury. They missed him, if for no other reason, blocking in that backfield. Now he is ahead of Thompson. Jacob goes to the right side. This is Thompson again. Short of that first down, Scott Summit, 73 of Davidsville, Pennsylvania, leading the defense that time.
Again, Summit, number 73, right here, is going to make a nice inside charge. What he does so well is get off on the snap. Watch how quickly he gets off, has a little slant inside, bites off the block of the guard, and then makes the play on Thompson. That's a very nice play by Scott Summit.
Third and short for the Nittany Lions. Needy to get a first to keep it going. In behind Gash, stuff, and leading the way, Chris Herring.
Well, Joe Paterno looks like he's going to punt the ball here, but it surprises me. You're losing by 17 points. If you give the ball back to Major Harris, you have to worry about that. I'm surprised. I would cut it straight over here.
And I don't think he has any option, given the field position and the way the defense is stuffing his running game. I think Belkowski's got to punt it.
And watch Chris Herring as he makes the play right here. We talked about his instincts a little bit earlier. Found a little soft spot, found a hole, and then made the play.
Hits it at the 30. Bell is back. Fields it at the 29-yard line. Jitterbug and down there at the 32-yard line. Darren Perry getting down with coverage. Held into a 3-yard return. So when you come back, it'll be Major Harris time again.
Yeah, you know, growing up, that was my first love, basketball. That's all we played where I'm from, you know, is basketball. You know, I didn't start playing football until high school. So, you know, basketball is my first love, and, you know, if I had a chance, I would probably want to play basketball.
He took Brasher High School of Pittsburgh into the state championship against Carlisle. Carlisle was loaded. Jeff Lebo of the Tar Heels and the Owens brothers, one a football player, the other an emerging basketball star at Syracuse. Major ran a great floor game, but they lost to mighty Carlisle. And now in the backfield, Aaron Evans and Undridge Johnson for the Major. He hands off to Undridge, and Johnson comes across to the 36-yard line.
Every quarterback I know always wants to be a basketball player. You ever notice that? We all want to be the point guard of the basketball team. Andre Johnson's a guy, although he's a backup tailback, he is a very unselfish player. He's rushed for over 100 yards their last two games. Never seems to complain when he gets his chance. He plays very well.
Down, the Major rolling to buy some time in the play. And his fullback out, that's Aaron Evans there. Second-year player out of Richmond, Virginia, with a penalty flag down at the 39-yard line. Against the defense. Penn State hurt by that personal foul call.
Brent, one of the reasons I think Major Harris is so good that he treats football as it should be. It's only a game to him, and he still has fun playing the game of football. And I think that becomes harder and harder in big-time college football. But he plays with a smile on his face.
So the penalty moves the ball across midfield and into Nittany Lion territory. First and 10 for West Virginia. The Mountaineers lead the Nittany Lions 17-0. 9.5 minutes to go in the first half. Major off a play fake. Look at the time. Look at the arm. Going long for Phillips. He's got it. Touchdown, West Virginia. Thank you. the point. Hammered through. 24-0. Get the adjectives ready. This kid's for real.
And take notice of Major Harris. This is against the will. He winds up and throws it all the way downfield to Calvin Phillips, who makes a nice adjustment on the ball. Phillips is finally emerging in his senior year, making a lot of big catches.
Yes, the ball are both drooling watching this team. And folks, they'll bring fans to your city for a bowl game.
You know, Brent, everybody thinks of the quarterback on big plays like we just saw, but the offensive line here set it all up. Koken again the center, Kovac the guard, Troyer the guard. Phillips had about 4 seconds to get rid of that ball. That's a long time for the protection to hold up.
What kind of a young man is Major Harris? Well, if you walk with him and you pass the ping pong table, he'd throw you a paddle and say, let's play. Just roll it out. Whatever the game, the Major wants to compete.
He probably beat you.
I wouldn't bet against you. Yeah. This time, Bauman kicks it off. Brown at the 7. 15. 20. Slam breaks the tackle. Running backwards to the 20. Now out to the 25. Turns upfield at the 29-yard line. One of the major unbeatens certainly rolling here today. West Virginia, UCLA with some early difficulties. Notre Dame rolling today. Wyoming with a big lead. And Arkansas, the strength of the Southwest Conference. But Arkansas still must go to the Orange Bowl to play the Hurricanes of Miami. I'll tell you a great game. I'll tell you a dandy. Miami and West Virginia or Notre Dame and West Virginia. Take your pick. Speaking of the bowl, Ara Parsegan coming along at halftime to talk for our Jim Nance. Now, there's a personal foul against West Virginia. They hammered Brown a little bit too hard on that kickoff return on that far side. The ball is brought out to the 44, and let's see how the freshman soccer goes now. Penn State badly in need of a score. Gash, filling at fullback. Incomplete, overthrew his tight end that time. David Jacob coming out of the backfield.
Brent, you mentioned it, and Brent and Era and Jimmy Nance are going to talk about it at halftime. I think this is a fun time of the college season where we really get into the bowl, start talking about them. You know, can a West Virginia team win a national championship, go undefeated? Remember 1984, BYU won a championship. Everybody said they couldn't.
Second and 10. The draw play with Thompson. Midfield, first down. Inside the 40, down to the 35-yard line. Chris Perry, number 49, all down for the Mountaineers, the 16-yard gain. Ball went out of bounds. You may have saw the ball come free, but because it went out of bounds, no fumble in that situation, and they'll have the first down, and Thompson goes over to talk to Joe, and now look, hold on to the ball. You got a great run. You coughed it up once last week. Now just hold it for me. Gary Brown replaces him. Time left in the first half. Pinson, the burner in motion. They run Brown. Battles his way to the 33-yard line with Darrell Whitmore, number 11, a bright young defensive back, ripping him up.
So Penn State has really had a four-week decline in the rushing attack. There you see Alabama a week ago, 71 yards. And right now, they're going to have any chance of keeping this team close, maybe not 53 yards today. They need a score here before halftime. They need a touchdown.
Second and short for the Nittany Lions. Here's the toss to Brown. And he battles his way to the 29. Could be a first down. Let's see where they spot the ball. He's out of Williamsport, Pennsylvania. 5'11", 200-pound running back.
He's been the guy that's really come up with all the big plays for Penn State this season, both in the rushing attack and as a receiver. A very good, clean receiver out of the backfield.
First and 10 for the Nittany Lions. Ball inside West Virginia's 30. Bouncing again. Saka throws complete inside the 15-yard line. And that was Michael Demford.
Virginia's offense, you don't think about much of their defense. 73 in the middle of the screen, Summit, that's the second big play he has made, just fights off the block of the All-American with Newski and makes the play.
Number 11, Darryl Whitmore, just limped off for West Virginia. Number 42, Tippy Shearer is in. Vince Abel threw it right away over the middle, complete inside the 10. The tight end battles his way to the 3-yard line. David Jacob being brought down by
quarterback is off to a slow start. You try to get the ball to the tight end because he's a big throw. It's an easy throw. He's right in front of you. So far, doing that. That
sounded like run running just to just run the option here. Something we haven't seen much from Saka as they bring the chains out to Major right now. We'll see if Paterno and the Nittany Lions have a first and 10 inside that 5-yard line.
They have not scored much, one touchdown in the last 10 quarters. They're bringing in three tight ends.
It's 11 quarters, adding the first one here today.
Here with 7 minutes left in the half.
Well, they get a little bit of a break, being just short. Get themselves an extra down now. Third and inches. Thompson is the tailback. Gash the fullback. Young is in there, along with Wolf. Three tight ends.
The coordinator, they're looking for two here. They move the ball to the left half.
Saka bending into the huddle. They'll have Daniel and Smith wide to the right. Dash the running back. Thompson is over there on the wing coming in motion. Three receivers on the right. Saka is looking back. David Daniel, sophomore from Sarasota, Florida, and now it is 24-8 after the two-point conversion by Penn State.
And Paterno makes it a 16-point long run, but a tough run by Gash. It was 2 weeks ago they thought he had a broken ankle. It was just a sprain. He came back and he showed great determination right there. The two-point play here, what Penn State was trying to do was get the man in motion in the flat quickly. West Virginia played a zone defense, took that away, and Saka showed some patience and then found David Daniels, number 26, right underneath the goalpost. A good play by Daniels.
The key man for the Nittany Lions, sophomore fullback Sam Gash of Hendersonville, North Carolina, his fifth touchdown of the season. He was injured and missed the Alabama game. Now he is back, and Henry Atkins has the ball on the tee for the Nittany Lions.
And if you're wondering why Joe went for two there, and he's thinking way ahead now, they're down by 16. He's thinking second half, he needs two touchdowns and a field goal if he can shut them out in the second half.
Remember last year, West Virginia had their team beat Penn State Rally. Brown scored the winning touchdown. Napoleon at the 9, 15 points. Down at the 28-yard line, and a penalty flag comes down. A penalty marker is down at the 28-yard line.
see if it was a late clip. Yes, it was. Now West Virginia beginning to make a few of those mistakes that can add up. 24-8. 6:50 to go in the first half. Evans and Johnson are the running backs for Harris. Moore is the tight end. Johnson coming wide to the right. He's taken out of bounds by Neil Hamilton, who's played a superb game. Let's check in with Jim Hamilton.
Quarterback Steve Walsh of Miami moves Pat Bernie Kosar into second on the Hurricanes' career touchdown pass list. With his 41st, it goes to Andre Brown, puts the team 17 up on East Carolina with 9 minutes left. Back to Brent.
All right, Jim, the Hurricanes are rolling, and here West Virginia leading Penn State 24-8. John Dockery and Pat Hayden, I'm Brent Musburger. Major Harris has put on a spectacular show in the first half. Really hands off to Johnson. Great fake that time. First down before Hamilton can tackle him at the 25.
Andre Johnson has great speed, but he can be deceiving because he doesn't have a whole lot of moves, and sometimes he appears slower than he is, and he can really fool a defense.
Now
left tackle, Brent, as you see right here, watch him come down and clear the way. The fullback is offset, and this is a little change of pace. They've always run to that fullback until today.
Now Harris running off of that option. Spins free from a tackler. Goes to Rico Rembert. He's out of bounds. Rembert, the junior college transfer, catches another one for 17 yards and a first and 10.
And another athletic play by Major Harris finding Reggie Rembert. This receiver is 6'6". He looks a little bit like a one-iron. He is so tall, he's 6'6", 200 pounds, but Major Harris finds the guy. He is a lean guy.
Could you handle a one-iron like that?
Heck no. And here's a 10 or 7-iron.
First and 10 for the Mountaineers. And here's Johnson pounding his way to the 47-yard line before Gianetti brings him down. Downstairs to John Dockery.
Brent, let me ask you a question. What happens when a coach gets his program going well and people are excited about it?
Well, they name an ice cream after.
Remember last year it was Paterno Peach? Well, this year here in Morgantown, it's Nifty Neeland Fudgeberry. Kind of a strawberry with a chocolate swirl. And I might add that Nifty Neeland is outselling Paterno Peach by a wide margin, with all proceeds going to Ronald McDonald House. Now back to you, Brent.
All right. Harris trying to buy time, and that time he could not get it off. The defense collapsed around him. Quinnis McDonald, 92, and Dane Dawson, 79, helped bring him down.
Again, another one of these key third downs for the Penn State defense. Again, what they need to do is stuff West Virginia now, give their offense a chance. They've scored their first touchdown in a long time. They've got some momentum, but get the ball back.
Jamie Lamont, number 15, in at wide receiver, going to the left. Phillips and Rembert to the right. On third and 7, look at the time the Major's got. Can't find an open man. Now goes to Phillips, complete. Inside the 15-yard line.
Your question is remarkable to me how accurate Major Harris is with a D-pass. A lot of guys can complete 60% of their passes when they're taking the ball, but he is completing 60% of his passes, throwing the ball downfield. Phillips is well covered. It's a frozen rope. He has done that twice to Phillips this afternoon.
Almost 200 yards in the air already here this afternoon. Two touchdowns. A field goal. They lead Penn State 20-48. They're threatening again. Evans and Quinnis Johnson in the backfield. This is Johnson right up the middle. Breaks free and gets inside the 10. Collins had him wrapped up. Couldn't bring him down. And Reed finally pulled the tough running back down.
No, from tackle to tackle, I think Andre Johnson is as strong as any running back I have seen this year in college. college football. And very much an unselfish guy. Very talented player. Played second team, but never complained.
Second down for the Mountaineers, and already short. Off that option, Major turns it up. And leads it out at the 6 foot. Andre Collins tackling the quarterback.
Major Harris is one of the few option quarterbacks I have seen with an accurate right arm. If you think about option quarterbacks, you think about the Oklahoma guys, they're great runners, but don't have the touch with the ball because they take such a beating. Harris is able to take that beating and still have touch on the football.
Making him perhaps the most dangerous quarterback in the land today. What do you do now with third and short going in? How do you set the defense?
Tyler, who went in motion, to call the offsides against Penn State. Very unusual to see a team like West Virginia who could give you some finesse and then hammer the ball down your throat.
Virginia leading Penn State inside of 3 minutes here in the first half. It'll be a first down for the Mountaineers at that 2 yard line. Tyler, the third fullback, stays in the game.
Over.